Ladies, it's Jaren. I am here today with a tag. This tag is from Pebbles Flintstone. She recently uploaded this video and I watched it this morning and I thought it was a great tag, so here I am to do it for you. So this is the My First Time tag, and I'm just gonna do the same questions that Pebbles did, and she's amazing. Hi, I love you. Okay, the first question was, do you still talk to your first love? I actually do talk to my first love. My first love was in high school. His name was Marco Galindo, and we grew up together. I mean, we grew up together, and we were together 3 years. We went through a lot of horrible stuff, and so we're actually just lifelong friends. It's been, God, 6 years or more like probably 10 years before we ever date, since we ever dated. I mean, I was like 17, and so yeah, we still keep in touch. We're lifelong friends, family friends, things like that. He was in my sister's wedding. He was the best man, and things like that. But I do have to qualify. I do think that my first real love is my current relationship. I don't think I really understood what love was until I was a little bit older and I actually knew myself. I don't know if you can really love a person until you actually know who you are. And so I actually would say that my current relationship is probably my first real love, and his name is William. Hi. I'm sure he'll watch this. And we've been together over 3 years. I'm sure we'll get married if he'll hurry up and, you know. But yeah, best relationship I've ever been in. We laugh, we're complete idiots. So William is probably my true love, my one and only. Okay, my first job was when, like, the day I turned 16, I could not wait to get a job because I wanted to buy stuff, and my mom was like, you can get a job. So I did that, and as soon as I was 16, my first job was at Pizza Hut, and it was in Guymon, Oklahoma, and I was a waitress. And I actually served beer, which, looking back, I think that might have been illegal because I think you're supposed to be at least 21 to serve beer. Now, maybe those laws didn't exist back then when I was 16, but I remember serving beer, and I remember serving pizza, and we would have this group of guys that would come in like 5 minutes before close and stay there for like 2 hours after. And I was in high school, and I was like, oh my gosh, I have to go home, I have to go to work. And I would be there till like midnight, and it was horrible. My first car was a bright red Ford Explorer, like, sport. It had two doors, and it was actually my mother's car, and then when I turned 16, she started driving my father's truck, and so it just kind of got passed down to me, and I drove that for several years until it, I don't know, we started calling it the Exploder because just one day it randomly started shooting out like fire hot air, even when the air was turned off. Like, the heater wasn't on, the air conditioner wasn't on, nothing was on, and it would like shoot hellfire from the front of the dashboard, and we took it to the repair shop, and it was like they took the temperature of the air and said it was like 150 degrees, but they didn't really know why. And so we were like, oh crap, we need to get a new car. And so that's what we did. So the Exploder was my first car. The first person I texted this morning was probably my boyfriend. He goes to work really early on the weekends, and I'm off on the weekends, and so I'll text him when I wake up and, you know, how's your day, how's work. The first person I thought of this morning, well, I guess it'd be more than one. I guess that I thought of my parents this morning. They are traveling from Oklahoma this morning, so I'm just kind of thinking about them, hoping they make it safe, and wishing them a good trip. The first person I spoke to this morning was probably the person at the gas station. I went to go get a Sunday paper and to get a Diet Coke, and so I said thank you. That's really all I've talked to this morning so far. And you guys. So you guys are the first person I've talked to. Okay. The first wedding I was ever in. I'm always the bridesmaid, never the bride. I've been in like four or five weddings. the first wedding I was ever in was one of my best friends growing up, Lindsay. She was Lindsay Stelzer. She's now Lindsay Short. And Lindsay and Bryson had their wedding, and I was a bridesmaid, and I had to get my dress like majorly tailored because it was long, and I'm like 4'11". So I remember that my dress was really long, and I had to alter it a whole bunch. But it was a beautiful wedding. She looked amazing. And they're still doing wonderful several years later. The first thing I did this morning, probably the first thing I do every morning, I wake up and I check my email, check my text messages, check my phone. I get a ton of email from work and from school and blah, 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 blah. The first concert that I ever went to, I think the first concert I ever went to was Nazareth. And if you know who Nazareth is, that is an old band. Nazareth sang Love Hurts, like old school, like 70s power rock. And they actually came to my hometown for this concert called Cornstalk. And it's supposed to be like Woodstock, but everybody had like corn because it was out in the prairie. I don't know. But I went and saw Nazareth, and I was probably like 10. Maybe, I don't know. And then I think this was after that, I went to a Dixie Chicks concert in Liberal, Kansas, when I was really young. And then I went to Ozfest when I was probably like 13. Excuse me, I have a cough. And I saw the original Black Sabbath before Zakk Wylde died. So I used to be like a big rocker chick. I used to have like green hair. It was horrible, but that's what high school's for, right? To kind of find yourself, whatever. So I think Nazareth was the first one, and it was amazing. It was amazing. So I saw a classic band. My first broken bone. I haven't had any broken bones that I know of. I mean, we pretty much all break a toe probably at some point when you stub it on something. But I'm not really a broken bone girl. I'm a stitches girl. I've had stitches all the way around my knee because I cut my knee when I was like 10. When I was having a snowball fight, I fell down and I landed on something. And my knee started gushing blood, but I couldn't feel it because I was numb because it was cold and I was having a snowball fight. And I ended up getting stitches. And my other stitches were from here to here. I cut my eyebrow off, I guess you could say. I was water skiing. The ski popped out of the water. The bottom fin of the ski went bloop and cut my eyebrow off. So they had to shave my eyebrow and stitch it back. And they didn't know if I would ever grow hair back, so I was kind of scared. I was like, I'm gonna look like a freak. But it did grow back, and I've kind of, over the years, it looks pretty good now. My first piercing was my ears. I got my ears pierced the first time when I was probably like 13. I told my mom I wanted to get them pierced. We went to Walmart, I got them pierced, and they actually got really infected because I did what they told me to do. They give you that little liquid and they say to put it on so many times a day, and I followed what they said verbatim, and it actually infected my ears. And then finally my mom was like, that's crap, you just need hand soap. And so we threw out the little ointment they gave me, and I just started using hand soap on my ears in the shower, and they were healed within like 2 days. So if you get a piercing, don't use the crap they give you, just use hand soap, like antibacterial hand soap. So yeah. My first foreign country I've ever been to. I've never been to a foreign country. I want to go to a foreign country, and I'm sure that I will go soon, but right now I am still in college and I am broke, so I don't travel. The first movie I ever went and saw, I love movies. I guess the first one I can remember seeing would probably be Lion King or Toy Story, whichever one of those came first, or Pocahontas. I saw all of those in theaters when I was really little. I love Disney movies. I still love them to this day. I own them all and I still watch them. So whichever one came first out of Lion King, Toy Story, or Pocahontas, that was the first one that I remember seeing. Doesn't mean it's the first one I saw. My first detention, oh my goodness, I never got in trouble in school. Are you serious? I'm a teacher. Like, no. I did actually get detention one time when I was a senior in high school for PDA. My boyfriend gave me a peck on the cheek. My little first love boyfriend, he gave me a peck on the cheek. And this teacher that literally hated his guts, she was like always out to get him. It was the weirdest thing. I don't know what. Actually, She hated him because he was in a Spanish dance group, and he was, like, a really good dancer, and he quit the dance group, and it made her mad because then they started losing competitions, and so she was out for his blood. Is that not the stupidest? So weird, so random. But she hated his guts. She saw him give me a peck on the cheek, and so we both got detention during lunch, and I just sat in there and just kind of, like, stared at everybody because I did not belong there. I didn't get in trouble. Hello. But that was my first and only detention. My first roommate, I don't know if this would count, I guess my sister. When I got my first teaching job, it was away from home, and it was in a small town where she also taught, and so we lived together, because we both taught there, and that was the only reason why we were there. So I guess my sister, and then my boyfriend, I guess. My first grade teacher was Miss Elliot. She was like, I loved her. She was just the sweetest, most like motherly type lady. The first time I was on a plane, I actually have never flown before. And I know that sounds insane. I'm kind of scared to fly. I know that I can't avoid it forever, but I really have just been so busy with school and work that I never travel for fun. I never travel for leisure, at least right now in my life, because I'm trying to get out of school again with a second master's degree and I'm broke. So I actually have never flown, and I'm excited to fly. I actually think I might be flying in May to one of my boyfriend's best friend's weddings in Nebraska. So hopefully I will be able to fly for my first time then. Who was my first best friend, and do we still talk? My first best friend was Megan Moon. We were best friends starting in second grade to like fourth grade, and then she moved to Amarillo, and I haven't heard from her since. So no, we don't still talk. Where was my first sleepover? Probably at like one of my cousin's houses. The cool thing about having like a gazillion cousins is that you can sleep over on like weekdays and stuff, and it's cool. I actually grew up on a street, and on the street was my aunt and uncle and my cousin, our house, another aunt and uncle and my cousins, my grandmother's house, and another aunt and uncle. So I actually grew up literally on the same block as all of my cousins, and so we would all just kind of sleep at whoever's house, and whoever would take us to school in the morning, because it was just my family that lived there. It was really awesome. So probably either at my cousin Chance's or my cousin Cassandra's house would probably be my very, very first sleepover. What are the first lessons that I ever took? The first lessons that I ever took were Red Cross swimming lessons. I actually started taking Red Cross swimming lessons when I was probably 7, 6, I don't know. I took them for several years. I took them from when I was like 7 to like 13 or 14, and actually became a licensed lifeguard. And the last question, who is the first beauty-related YouTuber I've ever watched? The first beauty-related YouTuber I ever watched was JLovesMac1 or Jarmaine. And I watched a video of hers, and I don't remember what the video was, but she was talking about, I don't know what it was, but it was something about girls who dress a certain way or something. And I literally cracked up so much that I watched like 10 of her videos just like that night. So that's all the questions. That is my first time tag. I tag all of you. I'll list some people that come to mind down below. But of course, you know who you are. You know who I talk to. You know that I love you all. And if you are my subby, do the tag and make sure you let me know you do the tag so I can watch it and learn more about you. So, I will link Pebble's video down below as well, and have a wonderful day. Thank you for tuning in.